New York Times editorial writer so lame on immigration that Trump trashing David Frum objected. What we have here is a person on MSNBC. I'm not really familiar with what her name is here. She's a New York Times editorial board member, of course, Mara Gay. And she was on this MSNBC show yesterday where she was making the case that all these people that are flooding in over our border illegally are, you know, asylum cases, I guess, in her mind, and that they're facing this mass violence in their countries. We keep hearing about this mass violence that's going on in these countries. No specifics, of course, but they just use that as an excuse for why it's okay for them just to come over here by the tens of thousands, you know, illegally entering the country and then claiming asylum once they're captured. Even though, you know, they do not meet the criteria for getting asylum. They just don't. Another person that's on the panel with her, David Frum. If you don't know who he is a never Trumper, for sure. I know him very well from when George W. Bush was president. He was a big pro-Bush guy. I often agreed with almost pretty much anything David Frum says. He and I were on the same wavelength. You know, I constantly defended him against media attacks. I defended Bush when I thought it was unfair, just like I do now. But he's a never Trumper. He is a Republican. He's a conservative, but he is a never Trumper, and he has done nothing but trash Trump since he was elected. But even someone who hates Trump as much as David Frum, and believe me, he does, go out and just take a look at some of his work. Even he couldn't just sit by and listen to this woman spout this nonsense. I'm going to go ahead and play it for you here real quick.
I would just say, you know, the reason that many of these people, these migrants, are coming to the United States is that because they are desperate and that they are fleeing incredibly violent experiences, whether through domestic violence or just the lawlessness in
Domestic violence? I'm not sure if what she was saying was like domestic violence within the country or actually like husband-wife violence. I'm not really sure, but these people always say this stuff. It's just like when they say that Russia interfered in the election. It's just this broad kind of baseless statement. Yes, I understand that Russia hacked the DNC servers, allegedly. I mean, we have to take their word for it. I have no way of knowing otherwise. But they'll say that Russia interfered, and then you ask them, oh, okay, well, to what extent did their Facebook ads or did their hacks, exposing Democrat corruption, how much did that actually sway the election? And they can't give you a number. They have no idea. It's just something that they say over and over. It goes from the media to their heads to their mouths, and they just spew it over and over again. So, I mean, what country is she even talking about? So right off the bat, what she's saying simply isn't true. And Frum's going to let her know. But before Frum said it, Obama said it. Obama said it when he was president, and he was quite clear. He said, typically refugee status is not granted just on economic need or because a family lives in a bad neighborhood or poverty. It's typically defined fairly narrowly. You know how it's defined? It's defined, and Frum is going to get into this, but asylum was meant for people who are being persecuted, you know, persecuted for their religion or their skin color or something like that, and their government's actually after them. There may be some narrow circumstances in which there is a humanitarian or refugee status that a family might be eligible for. If that were the case, it would be better for them to apply in-country rather than take a very dangerous journey up to Texas to make those same claims. But I think it's important to recognize that it would not necessarily accommodate a large number of additional migrants. Obama said such a system would keep smugglers from profiting off families, seeking better lives for their children, and it makes underground migration system less necessary. So what he's saying here is he's trying to make an argument that if you want to apply for asylum or for citizenship, do it from your home country. Don't come over here because it's dangerous. It encourages human smuggling. And it's overwhelming our systems because we can't accommodate this constant flow of people.
In some of Central America, you're shaking your head, but
the homicide rate in Central America has dropped by about two-thirds since it peaked in about 2011 and 2012.
It's been
declining ever since.
As you heard there, Frum said the homicide rate in Central America has actually declined by two-thirds since 2011, and thus the rate of migration has nothing to do with the levels of violence in South America. Exactly. I couldn't have said it better myself. So what he's saying is that the crime rates have been dropping there in these places, and these people are still flooding over here by the tens of thousands. I mean, it's just not never ending, apparently. We're just going to take in the entire country at some point. But that just demolishes her claim that they're coming over here for violence because of violence, and we just have to take them in because that's what America's always done. And I don't agree with that either. People came to this country in the past, they came through Ellis Island. They were registered as they came through. It wasn't just a mad dash across the border, and it certainly wasn't, caravans of never-ending of these people who don't have legitimate asylum cases. They just want to make money to send back to their homes. That's it. Melbourne jumped in and allowed Gay to push back and rule that illegal immigrants, quote, want a better life, and that many of them are fleeing violent situations, whether that be gangs or just violence in their own families, and a failure for their own state of their own states to protect them. I mean, we have domestic violence here. So that must be what she meant by domestic violence, because she says right there that, just violence in their own families. That's definitely not a criteria or an excuse to flood this country and overwhelm our systems, because make no mistake, these people are coming constantly. I mean, just the unaccompanied children alone, in 2018, there was 50,000 of them. And so that's a lot of people. We cannot continue to take this amount of people. The reason that there's all this trouble at these border facilities is literally because we cannot handle the amount of people coming. It's pretty clear to me, anyway, that these people are being organized and they're being sent here specifically to overwhelm our systems. Frum concludes after that and says the asylum system is not supposed to be a response to troubling people in societies. It's a response to persecution, which is what I was talking about earlier. That is, the authorities are coming for you. There's something because of something you can't control, that's benign, personal characteristic. Your state is persecuting you. Exactly. That's what the asylum system is for. And, this problem has been going on for a long time. It's not new. And we're trying to fix it. I mean, there's bills in there to fund ICE and the Border Patrol and to get improve these facilities, get more facilities, because we need them. These people just keep coming. What you're going to see in the media, especially the DNC media, which is most of the media, is that they're covering for Democrats. See, Democrats are not voting for this bill. They refuse to. And if they did, then we would get the funding. We could fix this problem. But then they wouldn't have an issue, would they? This is a great example of the media and the Democrats coordinating to manufacture a scandal. Now, here's the thing, is that this scandal existed before Trump got there. I mean, it was a problem all during the Obama administration. The media just didn't make an issue of it. This is an NPR article from 2016 about the trash-filled, crowded cells that they held migrants in, including kids, and the entire article goes on here without once mentioning Obama. So, I mean, this is a result of Obama's border policy. I mean, they talk about the Border Patrol. I mean, that's all controlled by the executive. And yet he isn't mentioned anywhere in here. And that's how Obama escaped blame. That's why they can say now that he was a scandal-free president, because they just wouldn't talk about him. They would never talk about Obama in connection with these problems, so that when people saw the story or thought about the problem, they weren't connecting it with the president. Somehow somebody else was to blame, not the president. He's such a great guy. He's basically God, as Newsweek magazine said. So just a great example of that. I actually tweeted Camilla here, and Camilla Domonoske, asking her why Obama did not appear in this article. And she actually told me because the lawsuit didn't name him and he didn't comment on it. Huh. So if Trump doesn't comment on any of this, then he's not going to be mentioned in articles? No, of course not. I found other articles by the same journalist and Trump everywhere. It's all, it's your typical anti-Trump rhetoric, just filled with it. So obviously she's got two standards here. I asked her why she thought Obama was disassociated from his own immigration policy. She never responded. I don't know if she just dismissed me out of hand or she read it and her brain broke, because she's like, huh, yeah, why is that? Maybe I'm a hack. Stephanopoulos and Bruce justify concerned Dems refusing to fund dire border facilities. So what we have here is a former Clinton administration hack, George Stephanopoulos, who pretends to be a journalist when he's actually a Democrat operative. On Good Morning America Today, the ABC News team behaved as if they were Democrats' collective lawyer, trying to defend and justify the reasons why Democrats won't fund the border detention facilities. After fretting over the poor conditions at these detention centers, congressional correspondent Mary Bruce and anchor George Stephanopoulos went out of their way to defend Democrats and blame Trump for the lack of funding. Of course, because, and the excuse they're going to give here is that Democrats don't want to support ICE. Okay? Well, I thought it was so important. It's so dire that these kids need to be attended to, need to be given more things. But they won't fund it. And they won't fund it because they want the issue. In fact, my guess is they'll take this right on into 2020. It continues. Stephanopoulos began by hyping the shocking conditions at one Texas border facility where resources like toiletries were limited and illness spread because of the sheer number of people overcrowding the facility. Again, no fault of our own. We only have so much space, people. That's why we're saying that it's not good that the Democrats and the left are encouraging this. So you have the Democrat and left encouraging these people to come, which is interesting because I read that article about Obama, and he straight up was arguing that they should not come that way, that they should apply from home and not come here that way. What we have here is it's a typical thing that I always talk about, the media, and what you have here is, former Democrat, Clinton administration officials pretending to be journalists going out and defending Democrats who are to blame. They won't vote for this bill to fund it. And so they're to blame. And so you got to get PR. You got to get some spin. And that's what George Stephanopoulos is here to do.
Overcrowding, lack of adequate food, soap, toothbrushes, or supervision. Our senior congressional correspondent, Mary Bruce, is on Capitol.
Right. It's so shocking. It's so desperate that we're okay with rationalizing Democrats not providing the funding needed to fix the problem.
Hill, where legislators expected to consider new border funding as early as today. Good morning, Mary.
Good morning, Georgia. Congress today is trying to rush $4.5 billion in emergency aid to the border to try and deal with these conditions that are being described as absolutely dire.
Absolutely dire, they're saying, but not dire enough to criticize Democrats for not voting for the funding. It's not that dire. No. Clearly, to these people they claim it's so dire and they care so much, but they don't care enough to criticize Democrats for not voting. The article continues, while ABC didn't seem concerned about these same conditions under President Obama, they characterized this problem for the Trump administration, not Congress. Stephanopoulos excused Democrats and Congress for holding up funding for these facilities, explaining that they were just following their moral compass against the president's immigration policy. Their moral compass? So they care so much, but they just hate Trump so much that they can't go along with it. They can't give him a victory, or they can't allow Trump to be seen as fixing the problem. They want to be seen as fixing the problem, which means they have to continue. They have to let the problem continue into the next presidency, which they're hoping will be a Democrat, which no doubt, you can mark my words on this, if a Democrat does win, you're going to stop hearing about this altogether, all this stuff. I don't even know what the hell they're going to talk about when because it's all going to change on a dime. The narrative overnight will change and it'll be something completely new. This border wall funding is being held up by some Democrats concerned if they approve the funding, they're going to be approving of the president's border policies they oppose. He noted empathetically that prompted Bruce to go out of her way to defend Democrats against their critics. She ended up laying blame on Trump. Yeah, George, everyone here on the Hill agrees that this emergency funding is needed. We need it because it's a dire situation. But the Democrats are divided because many of them are concerned that the president may use that funding to go ahead and fund tactics that they simply don't agree with to further his crackdown on immigration. Again, I'm confused about this because as I showed you earlier, or I might not have actually yet, but Obama was deporting, and he bragged about it constantly, how he had deported more people than any other president ever. Well, most of the parents U.S.-born children deported last year have been convicted of a crime. About 10,700 have no criminal convictions, although they may have fit other ICE priorities for removal, according to the reports. ICE said that 71,214 parents of U.S.-born children who were deported fit its priorities. 71,000, that's families that have been separated. And I brought this up in Twitter fights, and they always say, oh, well, yeah, those are U.S. citizen kids, and they got placed with other family members. Okay, whatever. Okay, now they're calling Trump, they're acting like Trump is going way above and beyond when, no, he's just doing the exact same thing that Barack Obama did, but that the media didn't have a problem with. This is about the only article on this I could find, and it is in the Huffington Post, which is a left-leaning source. There were 39,410 removals of parents who said they had U.S.-born children in the first half of 2013. 62% of those who were deported came from the interior of the U.S. So when Tammy Bruce says this, agree that emergency funding is needed, but Democrats are divided because many of them are concerned that the president may use that funding to go ahead with fund tactics that they simply don't agree with. So, they're talking about the deportation he was talking about a week ago, that he is now said that he's going to lay off of for at least a couple weeks, see if they can come up with some kind of a deal, which this is the deal that they're trying to come up with. They're trying to get this funding so they can fix this stuff. But the Democrats are too partisan, and the media is willing to back them up, like always. It's always the Republicans' fault. It's never the Democrats' fault. Stephanopoulos, former Clinton official, administration official, is defending Democrats because they won't fund the Border Patrol and ICE to hopefully fix this problem that they say is so dire, because they simply don't like Trump, and the media is willing to back them up on this. These people are hacks. They do not believe anything they're saying. They have no principles. Any principles they pretend to have is merely something temporary for political expediency. That's all I got for you today, folks. Thanks for watching. Please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. Of course, if you want to support this channel, you can always subscribe to me on Patreon or Subscribestar for $3 a month, or you can just send me a tip on PayPal. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all next time.